All right, we're going to do a word problem that uses exponents and or logs. And in this video, we're going to do this investment problem, seeing how long it takes for an investment to triple. So first, we have to know the compound interest formula, A equals P times 1 plus R over N to the NT. So here's our problem. How many years does it take for an investment of $4,000 to triple to $12,000? Now, I didn't have to tell you what it would triple to. You would simply take 4,000 times 3, correct? And it's put in a savings account earning 6% interest that is compounded quarterly. Quarterly means 4 times a year. And we're going to round our answer to the nearest tenth of a year. All right, so let's see what we know. We know that P is the original investment, and that was $4,000, and we wanted to end up at $12,000. We don't know what T is, but R is our interest rate, and that's 6%, so we could write 0.06 or 0.06. If you want to write it as a fraction, that's fine too. And N is how many times it's invested per year. So that's how we start the problem. So we're just going to fill those numbers in to this formula. So A, that's going to be our 12,000, equals 4,000 times 1 plus R, which is 0.06 divided by 4, to the 4T. I don't know T. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do here is divide both sides by 4,000. So on the left-hand side, oops, 4,000, here we go. I'm just going to get 3 equals, and this is going to cancel, so I just have what's in parentheses. So now I have to simplify what's in parentheses if I can. You can do that in your calculator if you want. I do a lot of stuff in my head first. I think of this as 4 over 4 plus 0.06 over 4, so that's going to be 4.06 over 4 to the 4t. And then you might want to just do that in your calculator, make sure it comes out evenly. And that gives you 1.015 to the 4t. Now I want you to think about this problem. What if I did not tell you the original amount was 4,000? I just said, how long would it take for something to triple? So what if I said I gave you $1,000 and wanted it to triple? I would have put 1,000 here, 3,000 here, and when I divide by 1,000, I'm going to get 3. So anytime you're doubling or tripling, it really doesn't matter what the original amount was. If you're going to triple it, over here you'll see a 3 when you're done, and if you double it, you'll see a 2. So the fact is that if somebody else has a different amount to invest in the same bank account, it's going to take them just as long to triple their money as somebody who invested $4,000. So think about that. All right, now how are we going to solve this? We have t, which is what we need to solve, right, the time, as an exponent. So that means we want to use logarithms. And again, you could always use your log or your natural log. This time, because it's a different problem, I'm going to use my natural log. So I'm going to take the natural log of both sides of the problem. So I'm going to take the natural log of 3, and then I'm going to take the natural log of 1.015 to the 4t. Now, once you do that, once you've written it in terms of logs, you could take this exponent, put it out in front of the log, and that's the key to seeing how cool logarithms are. So that'll just be the natural log of 1.015. Now, remember, natural log of 1.015 is simply a number, just like natural log of 3 is some number. And if you wanted to use the log instead of natural log in the end, it's not going to make any difference. Go ahead and do it twice if you'd like. All right, but the trick is I'm trying to solve for the t here, so I need to divide both sides by the coefficient of t. And 4 times Natural log of 1.015. That is the coefficient of t. I just sort of wrote the t in the middle. But remember, that's just a number. 4 times the natural log of 1.015. So what we want to do is divide both sides by that. So if I do that, I'll be able to solve for t. So on the left side, I'll have natural log of 3 all over 4 times the natural log of 1.015, and that will give me the exact value of t. So at this point, you want to get out a calculator and very carefully do this calculation. All right, with my calculations, I got that was going to be 18.447, you know, years. Okay, so there's actually more decimal places here. And you know you got something wrong if there's hardly any years, like if you got like a 0.05 years, of course it's going to take a long time to triple your investment. Okay, so just again, be careful. You might want to use parentheses all the way through. This is what you might put in your calculator. You might press the, if you want to do it all at once, parentheses, then natural log, then parentheses around the 3, and then another parentheses around all that. Then the division bar sign, which you might have a divide sign or something like this, then another parentheses, then 4, and natural log of 1.015. So, and depending on, you know, what kind of calculator you have, you might not be able to do all of this, or you might actually need another parentheses around the 4 times the log. Okay, so you might even need another parentheses here, depending on what kind of calculator you have. It really depends. But this was kind of a low interest rate, 5%, so it does take a long time. So we get t, and I said to round to the nearest tenth of a year. So it's about 18.4 years. So looks like it's going to take, it takes about 18.4 years to triple the investment. Now, we never want to be complacent and assume we always did everything correct, so let's go ahead and go back to the original formula, put in the 18.4 years, and see if it really does triple our investment. All right, so here's the original problem. And let's see if it's true if we put in $4,000 at that rate, if after 18.4 years, it has tripled to $12,000. So let's check it out. What would, okay, P would be 4,000, and they have 1.R, which was 0.06, and it was quarterly, 4, and it was to the 4 times 18.4. So what we want to do is calculate this, again, using your calculator, and we want to see if the amount really is $12,000. Okay, so we'd have 4,000 times, and then what did we get when we did 1 plus 0.06 divided by 4? That was 1.015, and then I have to do 4 times 18.4, and that's 73.6. All right, so now you put that in your calculator, and again, my suggestion is to make sure. I like to do this first and then multiply the whole answer by 4,000, but your calculator might let you just simply put in 4,000 and then the parentheses 1.015 is what I'm going to do. I'm going to try it. To the 73.6, and when I did that, so I actually just plugged in this exactly and my calculator did it, I got this number, and actually a little bit more, but I'm rounding to the nearest cent. I got $11,966.32. So you know what? It did Triple, because remember, I was approximating this 18.4, so my answer seems completely reasonable. Now, I'm going to take the same problem and just do it slightly differently about the check. Let's just see if it's true if I put any amount of money in, would it triple in 18.4 years? So, the question is, no matter how much money I put in there, will it be true that it gets tripled? Well, let's say I just put a dollar in the account. Let's see what happens. Well, if I put a dollar in the account, I just have one, right? Times 1. Remember when we plugged all these numbers in, we had 1.015, right? And that was to the 4 times 18.4. So basically, the question is, would that end up being $3? So we just need to do this computation in the calculator. Well, I got $2.99. So yeah, pretty much tripled. So that was my point. If you're trying to triple or double something, it really doesn't matter what the original amount is. So here's just one last way the problem could have been worded. So I could have just said, how many years does it take for an investment to triple if it's put into an account earning 6% that is compounded quarterly? You know what? All you know is that whatever you put in, you could just say is P, then the amount after that amount of time is 3p. So look how the formula works here. You have a equals p 1 plus r over n to the nt. Well, if I plug in 3p for a, if I divide both sides by p, look, you get 3 equals 1 plus r over n to the nt. So there's the formula if you want an investment to triple after a certain number of years. If you want to double, it would end up being a 2, because instead of 3p, you would put 2p up here divided by 2, and this is what it would look like. So just something to think about and consider. All right, but for our problem here, the answer was 18.4 years. Is that right? There it is. It took 18.4 years.